Hello,
this is Jihan Budak from the University of Washington. In this National HIV Curriculum mini-lecture, I will be talking about dolutegravir-lamivudine. Dolutegravir-lamivudine is an oral, once-daily, fixed-dose combination of dolutegravir, an integrase inhibitor, and lamivudine, a nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. It has few drug-drug interactions and no food requirements. A key point is that you must rule out hepatitis B infection prior to prescribing, as lamivudine monotherapy is insufficient treatment for hepatitis B. It is not recommended in individuals with renal impairment, as lamivudine needs to be dose-adjusted based on renal function, and this cannot be done with a fixed-dose combination such as this. It is not recommended in patients with severe hepatic dysfunction, and there is insufficient data for the fixed-dose combination's use in pregnancy. Possible adverse effects include headache, nausea, diarrhea, insomnia, fatigue, anxiety, and dizziness. However, it is generally well tolerated. The fixed dose combination consists of 50 mg dolutegravir and 300 mg lamivudine to be taken once daily with or without food. Use of dolutegravir-lamivudine has been studied as initial therapy and also as maintenance therapy. Here, we depict its use in initial ART therapy, which has several stipulations. It is meant only to be used in someone with an HIV RNA less than 500,000 copies per milliliter, who is hepatitis B surface antigen negative, and whose results from genotyping are known, and do not show resistance to either component. Its use in maintenance therapy has been studied in those who have already achieved viral suppression with three-drug ART. It can be used as maintenance therapy once that individual has had a viral load less than 50 for greater than or equal to 6 months, has no prior history of virologic failure, does not have hepatitis B, and does not have resistance to either component. As alluded to prior, dolutegravir-lamivudine is insufficient treatment for hepatitis B, so it is important to rule out hepatitis B, because if the person has chronic Hep B, lamivudine monotherapy should be avoided due to the possible emergence of lamivudine-resistant hepatitis B. Dolutegravir-3TC can only be used in these settings if another Hep B active agent is used. It is also important to recognize that discontinuation of dolutegravir-lamivudine may lead to an acute exacerbation of the hepatitis B. If Hep B is ruled out, then it is important to ensure the person is immune against hepatitis B, and if not, to vaccinate. We previously mentioned that dolutegravir-lamivudine has few drug-drug interactions. Although there are a few, key ones to mention are that the medication is contraindicated with dofetilide. In addition, dolutegravir concentrations are decreased with rifampin, polyvalent cations, some anticonvulsants, and St. John's wort. And we recommend looking up these interactions prior to prescribing, as in some instances, the medication should be avoided entirely, in others, a dose adjustment must be made, and in others, the patient should be counseled to separate timing of medication administration. Key studies for dolutegravir-lamivudine include the GEMINI 1 and 2 studies in those who are treatment naive, and TANGO and SALSA in those who are treatment experienced. GEMINI 1 and 2 are two identical, double-blind, randomized control trials of ART start in over 1,400 persons with HIV with a viral load less than 500,000, without hepatitis B, without any NRTI, INSTI, or major PI mutations. Individuals who are pregnant or breastfeeding were excluded. They compared an initial ART regimen of dolutegravir-3TC versus dolutegravir plus TDF-FTC. Week 48 results from GEMINI, shown here, demonstrate non-inferiority of dolutegravir-lamivudine in blue to dolutegravir plus TDF-FTC in green. The bars on the far left depict pooled data, and the bars in the middle and on the far right depict the percent achieving viral suppression by baseline HIV RNA level. It is evident that viral suppression among those on dolutegravir-3TC in blue and dolutegravir plus TDF-FTC in green are similar whether the viral load was above or below 100,000 copies per milliliter. This next slide, however, shows viral suppression rates based on baseline CD4 level. Drawing your attention to the middle and right bars, you will notice that if the baseline CD4 level was less than or equal to 200, then viral suppression in those on dolutegravir-3TC was 79% versus 93% in those on dolutegravir plus TDF-FTC. Though individuals with a CD4 cell count less than 200 only comprised approximately 8% of the overall study, I tend to avoid use of dolutegravir-3TC in individuals with a CD4 count less than 200. For Gemini 1 and 2, the week 96 results look similarly. Changing gears from ART start to ART switch, we will next review the TANGO study, which was an open-label, non-inferiority trial where approximately 750 adults with viral suppression on a 3- or 4-drug TAF-based regimen, and in this study, the fourth drug referred to a pharmacologic booster, cobicistat or ritonavir, were randomized to either continue the same regimen or switch to dolutegravir 3TC. Individuals had to be virally suppressed for over 6 months and were excluded if they had hepatitis B or C, had any history of virologic failure, or had a major NRTI mutation or any INSTI resistance-associated mutation. Drawing your attention to the middle bars on this graph of week 144 results, the percent of participants with viral suppression show non-inferiority between dolutegravir 3TC in the purple and their continued 3- or 4-drug TAF-based regimen in the grayish blue. Next, the SALSA study was an open-label, non-inferiority trial of approximately 500 persons with HIV with viral suppression greater than or equal to 6 months on a 3- or 4-drug regimen, randomized to either continue the same regimen or switch to dolutegravir 3TC. Similar to TANGO, individuals were excluded if they had hepatitis B or hepatitis C, had any history of virologic failure, or had a major NRTI mutation or any INSTI resistance-associated mutation. Drawing your attention to the middle bars on this graph of week 48 results from the SALSA trial, the percentage of participants with viral suppression show non-inferiority between dolutegravir 3TC in the purple and their current ART regimen in the grayish blue. We have summarized the results from Gemini 1 and 2, TANGO, and SALSA into this table as a resource. With regard to resistance, what we know from Gemini 1 and 2, TANGO, and SALSA is that rare virologic failure occurred and no treatment-emergent resistance was seen. In summary, dolutegravir 3TC is an oral, once-daily pill available as a fixed-dose combination that is well-tolerated with few drug-drug interactions and can be taken with or without food. We recommend exercising caution when administering a medication that decreases concentrations of dolutegravir, and also exercising caution in persons with hepatitis B. In fact, it should not be used in individuals with hepatitis B unless it is paired with another Hep B active agent. Dolutegravir-Lamivudine is a 2-drug option for treatment-naive persons with HIV without hepatitis B with a CD4 cell count greater than 200 and an HIV RNA less than 500,000 copies per milliliter. It is also a 2-drug option for treatment-experienced virally suppressed persons with HIV without hepatitis B, with no prior history of virologic failure, and no major NRTI mutations or any INSTI RAMs. Thank you very much.
The production of this National HIV Curriculum Mini-Lecture was supported by funding from the Health Resources and Services Administration.